The idea of this meeting was really intended for the city council to learn more from experts about these no-knock warrants. There is currently a so-called moratorium on that type of warrant in the city right now, of course, following the police shooting and killing of Amir Locke while serving one at a downtown Minneapolis apartment last week. So yesterday, the Minneapolis City Council's Policy and Government Oversight Committee heard from experts about the practice and other police procedures. A St. Thomas law professor was one of the experts they heard from, and she said according to national data, from 2010 to 2016, 94 people have been killed during the execution of no-knock warrants, in that 13 of them were police officers, leading them to believe no-knock warrants do not necessarily protect police either. Civil rights attorney Ben Crump also spoke about how the warrants disproportionately harm people of color.
As Bill Hutton, executive director of the Minnesota Sheriff's Association, recently acknowledged, no-knock warrants are most often used in urban settings, which I would add is where marginalized people of color mostly live.
Back in 2020, MPD did update its policy requiring officers to announce their presence before entering a building. However, that policy did give some discretion to officers if they felt that there was an imminent threat of harm.
Jen, thank you. And we're getting new details.